What's up, Tweener Heads? Welcome back to another Tweener Head Tennis video today here on the channel. And today we are going to be reviewing the new Adidas Barricade. Wait, this is the wrong shoe. The new Adidas Barricade. Here we go. It has been a long time coming. Finally, Adidas has given us a new Adidas Barricade shoe. The last Barricade I had, as you just saw, like, this is the ultimate classic shoe that everyone wore. This was the first pair of customized sneakers that I ever had. And for me, this was a time when Nike ID first came out with my Adidas as well. Like, I customized everything. I got the Italian flag. I wrote Fearless on the inside of the shoes. I made this all black, gold, red, everything. I made this to, like, be intimidating, like the Roger outfit that you wear at the US Open, wearing all black and just some hints of red. Like, that was the look I wanted to go for. And then I had some other Adidas Barricades. I believe I had the 7s as well, but I was very highly anticipating these shoes to come out. Now, this colorway in particular is the Tokyo edition for the Olympics that just happened this past 2 weeks. There is another colorway, kind of like the Ubersonic Force that I bought originally, the undercover one, kind of a striped zebra type of look. But these actually look really clean. We got white. We have, this is my favorite part, I'm not gonna lie, the huge Adidas writing on the inside. And from what I've seen, most of the athletes that are sponsored by Adidas aren't doing a combination of the sole core and the boost together. They're now primarily wearing just this, which is nice to see that Adidas is making a shoe that everyone seems to be enjoying. Because even with the Ubersonic 4, it's a shoe that I love and still use primarily to compete in. A lot of people were still using the Ubersonic 2s. They weren't using the 3s at all. A lot of them would not even use those 4s until recently for the clay season, which a lot of people seem to be using a lot. So for me, when I found this shoe, when I saw it come out originally, I had to have it. So I grabbed my credit card, my debt that I owned, and I threw all my money at it. I think it was totally worth it, though. Something that Adidas is really proud of itself for is the amount of recycled materials that it has for the shoes that they produce. 50% of the upper of the shoe is made of recycled materials. Even the box that it comes in says end plastic waste, and Dominic Thiem has been known to say, right, save the ocean and you recycle more in his post-match signing of the camera. Now, for this shoe itself, something that I found interesting is I don't think any shoe has a regular tongue now. I think all of it comes with a full tongue. And something that I noticed about this shoe, it's kind of halved. So the beginning of the shoe shows it a tongue right here where it goes under to where the toe is. But then once you get to the top part, it's more of a tongue. So when I strap in my shoes, I pull up on the tongue to make sure it's going all the way up. But I feel like that's a little bit harder with this because you can't even move it up since it's attached at the bottom of the shoe for that tongue feel. For the laces, they go straight into the shoe itself, the side of the shoe. They interlink into each other. And they have that loopy material that the Ubersonic 4 has where they would just hold right there inside the material. So if you just take a look, the other colors that it has, you see these loops that the strings go through. Now, something on the bottom, regular traction like a hard court would have, kind of reminds me of a more clay court pattern. If we take a closer look at that, reminds me more of a clay court pattern of a shoe for a hard, that, which for me doesn't necessarily look like a traditional hard court bottom. But something that it does have is something called the torsion system, I should say, because it lighter material inside, plastic, different, not just straight across, but kind of intertwining the top and the bottom. Kind of like if I took this Lacoste shoe, something that we did a review on, see how there's nothing connecting in between and it feels kind of stiff and there's like a hole in between? Adidas seems to be taking away that gap. With this, it's combining the top and the bottom of the sole, which provides for more comfort and stability. And something that I was finding out while I was wearing the shoe, while I was hitting, was that just like the original Barricade that I wore as a kid, the Barricade now still has that heavy bottom feel, but so sturdy of a feel at the bottom where I felt like I was in control the whole time and my foot was not slipping inside of the shoe, which I particularly loved. That's why I loved using the Adidas Barricade. The only reason why I didn't wear these shoes a lot was because I got them a size too big, but I'm glad I got these. I got a 10.5, and for me, the size fits very well. So I would recommend you guys either don't go a full size up or down. Go half sizes if you're going to get this shoe. So, but I do enjoy it. Another thing that I noticed is something called the GeoFit that it has around the heel. Now, with this GeoFit, it's adding padding inside this heel. There's about 6 patterns around the heel with extra cushioning for you and your heel. Now, something that I noticed when I was just wearing these when I was practicing or when I was out with the kids teaching is that there is a gap between this side of your foot and the shoe. And I don't know if that's because I didn't tie the shoes tight enough, but for me, when I was standing, there was a gap in between that GeoFit on the left-hand side and my foot. And I tied it a little bit tighter when I was hitting, so it did feel a little bit better, but I was questioning whether or not it was the right size and whether or not it was the right fit for me, because I was afraid my heel was going to slip. But thanks to that extra padding that it has, didn't really move as much. I'm going to have to give these a longer test to see how well they do the longer you wear them. And the last thing I have to comment on, a bit of a negative, but when I first put these shoes on, the heel, this high heel that it has on the back of your foot, really comes up into my Achilles. And it's not like a terrible feeling, it's just some discomfort, just like on the Ubersonic 4s, where I bend at the top of the shoe and it has that little plastic piece right here. It's something to get used to, and it is a higher heel than most of the shoes I do wear, and it's more sturdy, and I think that's what really makes the difference with this. So it really does contain and hold your foot for a very good reason, because you can definitely slide in these, you can move around them. They're on the heavier side of the shoe, but if you like having the stability of these shoes, I would highly recommend you get these. I do like wearing these. I want to do some more tests, so if you follow me on Instagram and Twitter, you can find those down in the description below. You guys can follow along with some more insights that I have on this shoe. And I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Let me know what kind of shoes that you want me to test in the future. I do have a Nike pair that I am very surprised that I got myself, but I can't wait to show you guys that probably next week. And I hope everyone is staying safe. I hope everyone is having a great weekend. Make sure you are subscribed to the channel. We're trying to hit 2,000 subscribers by the end of the year. So hit that subscribe button with notifications turned on. And I hope everyone is doing well and safe. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thanks, guys.